right, hi guys. So let's learn Kaisi Paheli zindagani. And basically the scale is B flat major. So it has two flats. Let's go through the scale. That will help us starting off. It's always good to get the foundation right. So you have the two flats are B flat and E flat. Okay. And the chords are basically going to be chords of the B flat major scale. Since it's on the major, a lot of the sections, actually all the sections, will start on the B flat major chord. And then, of course, there are a few minors to spice things up. So the chords are B flat major, which is the 1, E flat major, which is the 4, and F major, which is the 5. And then the minors, which is the 2 minor, the 3 minor, and the 6 minor, right? 2 minor is C minor. The 3 minor is D minor. And the 6 minor is G minor. Now, not all of these chords are going to be used in this song. Obviously, right? It will be chaos otherwise. Which is why a neat chord progression has been developed over the track. Okay? So, the underlying rhythmic feel of this song is swing. Okay? So, if this is your pulse, and if you're counting 8th notes, you'd be going 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, right? Swing feel will make it 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and ta ta da ta da ta da ta ta da ta da ta da ta da. So the entire song, even though this is the pulse, you need to move that 8th note a bit. It's not tan 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 tan. That would sound really funny, right? So it should be tan tan ta dang ta dang ta dang tang. So another way to count swing would be to feel it as a triplet. 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 and knock off the 2. 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 tang. Ta-dung, ta-dung. So a lot of blues songs, swing songs and jazz songs have this sort of a vibe. In fact, even the song which this was inspired from obviously has the same vibe, right? You can search for it on YouTube if you want. Anyway, another important thing about the feel or the rhythmic aspect of the song is when you're counting, you don't need to count all the beats. 1 2 3 4 1 You can basically focus on the 2 and the 4. 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 Or you can snap 2 3 4. So if you are a singer or a bass player or anyone, try to first hum your part or hum the tune. Ta na ta na ta na ta na na ta na 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 na, and so on. Always snap at the 2 and 4. That'll really get you into the song. That's also what your audience is anyways going to do in the first place, right? So sometimes we tend to count all those 4 counts. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Which is, you're not going to feel the swing. Okay, so that's about the rhythm. So the entire song is going to be on that dunk ta dunk ta dunk ta dunk ta swing feel. Now let's just see how it works on the piano. And by looking at the way I'm playing it on the piano, I'm sure you can figure it out on your instrument of choice as well. If you play bass, you can follow my left hand. Or if you play guitar, I'm sure this will also help you. So let's look at the introduction first on the piano. The introduction chords are B flat, G minor, C minor, F. So that's essentially a 1, 6, 2, 5 progression. A very, very popular jazz progression. In fact, this is influenced greatly by a jazz song, okay? By Louis Armstrong. Anyway, so the good rhythm pattern to play on the piano or the guitar or anything would be... What I'm doing on the keyboard is left, right, left, right, left. It's basically like you're marching with your hands, right? And this is your intro. If you're starting off, you can play like this. If you are able to play a little bit, if you're at an intermediate stage, perhaps you can add this technique.
Thank you.
So I'm adding an additional B flat to give you, to push you to feel that swing, right? Bum, pa bum, bum, pa bum, bum, pa bum. It's also nice to sing it as you play. You'll get the timing better. Anyway, a few points about the intro chords. The C minor, you can play as a C minor 7th. You can add the 7th to make it more jazzy. So, pum, pa bum, pa bum. Definitely makes it very jazzy. And then he ends with an F augmented chord. So you could also play F major there. But what happens with an augmented chord? You take the fifth and you raise it or you sharpen it. So C becomes C sharp. So it creates a very, very interesting mystical kind of sound, right? Okay. So let's see how it goes. Mm. Ba-bum, 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 bum. You can even play that, bang it a little harder. Mm, ba-bum, 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 bum, ba-bum, 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 and so on. So this same rhythm, pretty much, with a small modification, can be used for both the verse as well as the chorus. So let me just show you how this works for the verse, and then we'll do it with the singer. Okay, so the verse, the chords are basically B flat. Na 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 na. So let's see what pattern I'm doing. B flat, ba bum, bum, ba bum. Very different from the intro, because the chords changed a bit faster at the intro. So you go bum pa bum bum pa bum. It's all the bass. It's not really my right hand. My right hand is going to do the same thing throughout. And the right hand could definitely even work on the guitar, and the left hand could definitely work on the bass guitar. Bum pa bum bum pa bum bum pa bum. Bum, ba bum. It's the same principle. The root of the chord, chord, then the root again, and then the fifth. Bum, ba bum. So F is not played above B flat. It's played below B flat here, right? Dung, da dung, dung, da dung. C minor 7. Ba bum, bum, ba bum, bum, ba bum, bum, ba bum. Back to B flat. So think of the chords for verse and chorus as two B flats, two C minor sevens, two Fs, and by the way, F is more of a dominant seventh sound. Right? Again, makes it very, very jazzy, which is F major normal with that flat seventh you see there. This would have been the normal seventh. You flatten the seventh to E flat. Okay, so the chords for both verse and the chorus are B flat double, C minor double, F seventh double, and B flat. In the chorus, there's also a nice stop which I've marked with this X here. You'll see it as we play it along. So I'll first do it with Indu a bit slower, and then we'll perhaps do it at the normal speed. Okay, so try to follow, and it's always a good practice to. If you're a guitarist or a keyboard player or any instrument player, try to do it with the singing in mind. That is very, very important. Don't isolate your part. Otherwise, there'll always be that additional burden of going to the band room and again getting stuck with the singer. When the singer will add a different thing altogether. So it's good if you are with the melody. The chords, remember, are there to support and to serve the melody. So that's your job if you're playing the chords. Okay, and there's a nice groove to go along with it. So let's do the verse whenever you're ready. That's C minor. Kaisi paheli hai, kaisi paheli zindagani. Back to B flat. One more time, little slower. And it's pretty much the same for the chorus. Let's try the chorus. I guess you call that the chorus. But anyway, let's try it. So the chorus, you have to wait for the singer, right? So la la la. When you come in at the what, the fourth la, I guess. Yeah. Yeah. We'll do it. I think you'll figure it out from there. Yeah.
La 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 la.
Yeah. Same chords.
La,
C minor, F, B flat, stop. To stop at that part. So at the very end of the chorus, you stop. So that's pretty much all the vocal parts. The lyrics change. The music is going to be pretty much identical. There's a nice instrumental section which is played by the horn players. And then there's a saxophone playing pretty much the same notes as the verse. So let me just quickly show that off to you guys. However, if you're happy not playing that, it's also cool. You can let someone else play the melody. But anyway, here's the melody of the instrumental part. I've written it down. I'm just going to sing it and play it for you guys. Okay? So let's go. Ba 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 ba. 2, 3, 4. Ba. Okay, let's break that down. So, that's B flat, 3. And this goes against the B flat major chord. So, you can play the other notes as well. Ba 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 ba, lower C, 2, 3, 4. Ba. So this is like a trill on A. Da 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 da. That's with E flat major and the F. And in your left hand, you basically play the roots, and a nice pattern in the left hand could just be root. Octave, root, octave. And the saxophone pretty much plays the same melody as the singer. That needs no introduction at all. I have anyways written down the notes. Two, three. Right. So have fun playing this song, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.